Hi, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to share with you a very quick example of using Arduino Nano and also attached with the I2C LCD together with the Bluetooth module and also a sensor. So in this episode, I'm going to explain and give you an idea about interfacing with the I2C sensor named as SHT21. So this sensor is particularly very useful to detect temperature and also humidity when you are trying to investigate the indoor air quality issues in your office, in your house, or in any micro environment. So let us begin with the interface of this Arduino set. So the first one, you have the LCD being connected with the I2C modules, and then this I2C module will be interfacing with the 5 volt and then together with the ground. And then for the SDA, are being connected at the A4 of the Arduino Nano. Together with the another one, which is the SCL, are being connected to the A5 of the Arduino Nano. So the next one, I'm going to just giving you an idea of using the SparkFun BME280. Able to find the SHT module, but for the sake of example, let us just use this BME to imagine that this is the SHT21. So similarly, we have the 5 volt and then we have also the ground. So 5 volt go to the 5 volt of the Arduino, and then the ground go to the ground of the Arduino, and then we got the A4, or we call it as the SDA, are being connected to the breakout of the SHT, and then together with the A5 at the SCL, and then we have the Bluetooth module over here. So as you know, the Bluetooth module that we are going to connect is basically attached at the digital pin number 2 and 3, where the RX are being connected to the digital number 2, and then the TX are going to be connected at the digital number 3. So that is the example of the layout. So in this idea, I'm going to interface it with what we call it as the Arduino blocks. You can find out the blocks and the creations of this coding inside the descriptions of this video, because this is a very quick one. And then after you manage to create this kind of Arduino blocks, you might want to go to the block and then you can upload it. You can download it to produce the Arduino IDE sketch. However, it is not complete due to the fact that we need to install a certain library with regard to the use of the SHT21. So I already make some changes with regard to that, and then the explanations towards how you want to interface that one will be sharing in the separated video, because I just want to make this video very quick. So you can just see here, we have all the things that being set up and then initialize everything, and then we can hit the upload mode, and then we can upload the code inside our Arduino setup, and then we can see all the functions with regard to the temperature reading and also RH are going to be presented in our LCD. And then in fact, the Bluetooth module over here also are going to be sending the data through the Bluetooth connectivity to our mobile phone. So the reason of doing that is basically to capture a certain information, and then we want to make our smartphone as one of the device in collecting the data in the real time, and also data logging it so that we can produce a CSV file later on to make statistical analysis. So let us just have a look, a quick one. So the serial monitor already detect everything in according to the order that we are creating it, and then inside our smartphone also, when we go to the serial Bluetooth over here, when you go to the serial Bluetooth over here, you can also see that we can connect this one, and then after being connected, the temperature and also humidity are able to be read on our smartphone. So the reason of being connected it to our smartphone is just for the purpose of logging up your data over here. You can see there is a lock. When we lock this one, then the data are going to be saved inside our phone, and then later on can be transferred through our PC so that we can make a further analysis. So that is a very quick one to use the SHT21 with your Arduino Nano or even Arduino Uno also can. Just you need to change the connectivity and so on via Bluetooth connection, and also using a graphical programming language known as Arduino blocks. So hopefully you find this video useful, and then if you want to know more about the comprehensive video of how to understand the way that we want to code this thing, please refer also to the descriptions of the video or find out any links at the end of this video session. With that, thank you very much. See you again. Enjoy making. Bye bye.